Hello friends, now we will see chapter number 3, current electricity, and it is the first part of chapter number 3. In the beginning of this chapter, there is a term electric current. We know the definition of electric current from 10th standard. It is very easy. In 10th standard, what it was? Electric current having symbol capital I. As per 10th standard, it is net amount of electric charge passing through the unit area of a conductor in a unit time. Clear? So same definition is here. What is electric current? Electric current is net amount of electric charge passing through the unit area of a conductor in a unit time. From this, it is very easy. What is this electric charge passing in a time? Means electric current depends upon time. Simple, we have its unit also. Electric charge was invented by one scientist, Coulomb, and time always in second. Right? So Coulomb per second, it is a unit of electric current. But electric current was invented by one scientist, Ampere. Right? Or you can write as a symbol capital A. Electric current, it is present in 7 physical quantity. So it having dimension formula which M0, L0, T0, A1, or in short you can write A1 only. It is also valid. Okay, so again, what is the definition of electric current? Electric current is nothing but net amount of electric charge passing through the unit area in a unit time. Electric current depends upon time. So, as time increases, electric charge passing through the conductor increases. So, we can say that electric current depends upon time. It having unit ampere. It is the name of scientist and having dimension formula A1. There are two smaller units, 1 milliampere and 1 microampere, as we have seen in 10th standard. Milli means 10 raised to minus 3 ampere and micro means 10 raised to minus 6 ampere. So this is all about electric current. In 10th standard, we have seen electric current through the conductor. Same topic is there in 12th also. Okay, inside the conductor, why electric current flows? You know that. What is conductor? Conductor, it is a material which consists of free electrons. What is free electrons? How? Let us see. Suppose this is a conductor. For our convenience, let us see, this is nucleus of a conductor and these are the orbits in which electrons are revolving around the nucleus. We know that in first orbit there are 2 electrons, in second orbit 8. Second orbit having sub-orbit, again 8 electrons. 18. In third orbit and in fourth orbit, 32 electrons are present. Suppose, let it be. This is outermost orbit. In this outermost orbit, suppose electron is present. So you can say that outermost orbit is unfilled orbit. And we know that if this electron is very very far from the nucleus, so that nuclear force on the electron which is present in outermost orbit, this nuclear force is weak. Okay, so because of this reason, if we will give small amount of energy to the electron present in outermost orbit, this electron come out through the orbit. This electron is known as, what it called? It is known as free electron. And this free electron is moving inside the conductor anywhere. And because of this free electron, electric current flows through the conductor. Right? So it is about electric current and electric current in a conductor. Okay? Now let us see second topic. Second topic is about Ohm's law. What is Ohm's law? Let us say Ohm's law under fixed physical condition. Which condition? Under fixed physical condition, that condition is T, temperature. Temperature will be constant. So, under fixed physical condition, electric current passing through the conductor is directly proportional to electric potential across the end of a conductor. Right? So, this is a mathematical form of that Ohm's law. Simple. See, under fixed physical condition, which condition? It will be asked in MCQ or logical question. Under fixed physical condition, if temperature of a conductor is constant, then electric current passing through the conductor is directly proportional to electric potential across the end of a conductor. Clear? So, this is the proportionality sign. Want to remove this proportionality sign? Yes. Then you have to put equal to sign and you have to take a constant R. What is R? R is a constant, and this constant is known as resistance. Resistance of a conductor. So what is resistance? If we will make a subject R, then R is equal to V by I. R is the resistance. Now let us take its unit V, electric potential. In second chapter we have seen electric potential having unit volt, electric current having unit एम्पियर. सो वोल्ट पर एम्पियर इट इज अ यूनिट ऑफ रेजिस्टेंस आर एंड इट वॉज इन्वेंटेड बाय वन साइंटिस्ट ओम. सो वोल्ट पर एम्पियर और यू कैन से इट इज ओम. क्लियर. और इट हैविंग सिंबल लाइक दिस ओम ओमेगा ओम. क्लियर. सो व्हाट इज रेजिस्टेंस, व्हाट इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ रेजिस्टेंस, दैट वी विल सी लेटर ऑन. बट इफ वी विल टेक रेसिप्रोकल ऑफ रेजिस्टेंस दैट इज वन अपॉन आर, वन अपॉन आर इज नोन एज कंडक्टेंस. क्लियर. सो कंडक्टेंस, व्हाट इज कंडक्टेंस, दैट इज रेसिप्रोकल ऑफ रेजिस्टेंस इज नोन एज कंडक्टेंस एंड इट हैविंग यूनिट इज इट रेसिप्रोकल ऑफ रेजिस्टेंस सो यूनिट ऑल्सो इनवर्स दैट इज एम एच ओ और यू कैन से दैट इट इज ओम इनवर्स और ओम इनवर्स और मो. क्लियर. सो दिस इज अबाउट रेजिस्टेंस एंड दिस इज अबाउट कंडक्टेंस. इज इट. नाउ लेट अस सी व्हाट इज द डायमेंशन फॉर्मूला ऑफ दिस आर. सो वी हैव इक्वेशन वी बाय आई. In second chapter, we have seen what is V. V is nothing but work done per unit charge. Got it? What is I? What is Q? From this equation, I is equal to Q by T. From where this equation come? It is nothing but definition of electric current. That is, electric charge passing through the unit area of a conductor in a unit time. So from this you will have Q is equal to I T. Put this value here. So you will get R is equal to W upon I square T. Now place the dimension formula only work. In previous videos we have seen work, energy and torque, they having same dimension formula. Which one? 122 minus. That means M1 L2 T minus 2. 122 minus upon I square. I means electric current ampere, ampere square T time T1. Take it upside. So we will have M1 L2 T minus 3 A minus 2. So this is dimension formula of resistance. Clear? Again let us see what is Ohm's law. This is the statement, simple statement. Under fixed physical condition, so in bracket you have to write temperature constant. It will give positive impression to the examiners. Okay. Under fixed physical condition at constant temperature, electric current passing through the conductor is directly proportional to electric potential across the end of a conductor. Put constant. That constant is known as resistance. Now what is resistance? Right? So resistance, it is a property. Whose property? Resistance, it is a property of a conductor. Which property? To oppose. The flow of electric charge. Right? So what is resistance? So it is a simple definition of a conductor. So resistance is a property of a conductor to oppose the flow of electric charge. Clear? So this resistance is less for say now what a conductor, and resistance is more kona made insulator. Got it? So this is about resistance. Simple, you have to keep in mind a few concept. Resistance, it having unit ohm. Inverse of resistance, conductance, right? Dimension formula of conductance is reverse of this, means conductance having dimension formula, check it out, 1 2 3 2, means conductance having dimension formula, that is M L T A. As it is reciprocal of R, dimension formula will be inverse, means M1 here -1, L2 here -2, T -3, so it is +3, A -2, it is +2. Clear? So it is about Ohm's law, resistance, conductance, its unit, dimension formula.